Hi, it's Jess here from Nigezza.co.uk. Thank you for joining me today. It's Wednesday, so it's junk journal time, and I've been busy making lots and lots of ephemera. And I wonder if you have any idea how I made these things. I took some copier paper, just normal copier paper. This is actually acid-free copier paper, and I just used ink and stamps to create these vintage-looking pieces of paper and old book paper to create these. So they aren't coffee stained. They aren't cooked in the oven. They are made with ink and stamps. So let's see how I did it. So I made all those. That was just two sheets of A4 that I did that with. And I've used Stamping Up Crumb Cake and Soft Suede. And I've used Fanciful Fragrance, Parisian Beauty, Very Versailles, and believe it or not, Painted Poppies. I've just used that stamp there. That gives a lovely effect of, which I discovered, of as if it's been coffee stained. Obviously I use the script in this. I love the script in that, and I do use the postmark. And in this one I like the script, and I do like the perfume bottles as well. So the first thing you've got to do is stain your paper. So I literally took, one of them was darker than the other. So I did, she drops it on the floor. So this was one sheet of A4, and I used my envelope pump butch board to make the envelopes. And then with the scrap left over, I made this cute little folder with just a little bit of, this was Whisper White. This was coffee stained and cooked in the oven actually, but I'm gonna do some that's not. But on this one I was top heavy in Soft Suede, and then this sheet, actually I think that one was actually coffee stained, this one wasn't, this is done with my A4 sheet, and this one was more crumb cake with little bits of Soft Suede, so you can get different effects. So I will it's kind of first generation, second generation. So I'll move those back out of the way. It's got a lovely feel to it because I've then put book paper on. It really does feel quite old. And these bits of paper were from my teaching days. So these were sort of like, I used to always print if I was making teaching resources, I would print them off to sort of test them out, and so I kept them all, so I don't like throwing things away, and so yeah, I just did it on that, so it really is junk. So not that my teaching resources were junk, but so all I did, I'm using my glass mat, is I just went round on my glass mat with the two colours, like so. I do like getting messy, I've been doing a lot of that. So, getting very inky on my hands. And then I took a spritzer, and I just sprayed a bit of water on there. And then I got my piece, and I just put it down, and then moved it around a bit. And I just did the one side because I stuck book paper to the other. And then I sort of squished it around. to use up all that ink. I've got some quite sort of squareness going on there, but it all sort of, it all gets evened out, so it doesn't really matter. So there, so that one's quite dark. So I'm going to add some more and get a sort of a lighter effect. I think I might have used Sahara sand, actually, thinking about it, as well, which is a much lighter shade than Crumb Cake. So I'm just going to do some dots of this. Not a lot. And then we'll get our little spritzy. Takes the lid off, please, Jess. Oh, I just sprayed the window. And now you can, to get rid of those bits, you can do some swirly. So we've got less blobs. And then might take, and then we take our sheet and just you do get a similar effect to when you coffee dye, and you get it sort of pulled, you get some interesting, and each sheet will be unique. So you can see that one's not as dark as that one. So we've got the sort of two different effects going on. I'm going to get Sahara sand because that's much lighter. So this is the Sahara sand, and I'm going to put some of that down. So I'm going to do the cardstock now as well. And stick in a bit of Crumb Cake. And just a bit of this one. You can do it with any of the inks you've got. It's a water-based ink. You'll be able to do this. So I just have Stamming Up inks. I've got a few Tim Holtz, actually. Got Vintage Photo. I've got Soot. I've got some greeny ones. I do have a purpley one, actually. There we go. And then I'm going to spritz it again and then get my cardstock, because I do want some Whisper White. I'm using Whisper White. I'm not using Very Vanilla. I like to use the Whisper White. So I was just playing around the other day, it was on Zoom, crafting with my sister and my niece, and we were just doing our own thing, chatting, and I was experimenting with this. Now I do want this on both sides, so I'm going to put some more ink down. I'm going to do both sides, and then you can leave it to dry. Naturally, you can help it along with a heat gun. I helped it along with a heat gun, which was the quickest way of doing it, and I will probably do that today because it's actually Tuesday today and I want this out tomorrow. I thought I had some already filmed and in the bag, and I didn't, so I came up here this afternoon to film, and then I just got lost in my junk journal, and I've got almost the first signature completely done, and obviously I'm doing the third signature with you, and then the middle signature will just get done whenever. that is actually nearly dried already. And so it's just really handy to, I was trying to work out a way that I could actually do this sort of, I wanted a coffee stain effect without using the oven. And if you just wanted a quick piece, then this is quite a good way of getting a quick piece. So I did do a little bit of dragging, gives you a different effect. And so there we have it. So where's the other two sheets gone? Oh, there they are. So the paper, I've only done one side because I am going to stick book paper on that. But this one, I've done both sides. But this isn't it finished. We're then going to do some more things to it. So I'm going to get that dry and get back to you. So they're all dry. I just use my heat gun to make sure that they're dry, and they are pretty dry. And I've mounted my stumps. And so what I did was I just did some random folding, and I used soft suede and one of these. Sometimes I use daubers, sometimes I use blending brushes. Anyway, so I just made creases and inked, so to give the impression that the thing might have been folded up for a very long time, getting old, in an office somewhere. So I made a few of these creases. Document like so, and I'll carry on and do that with the others. I'll just show you, actually, I think it'd be good to see the contrast. I might do this but speed it up for you. So that's my crease is put in. Now the cardstock, I don't actually want to fold the cardstock, so I'm going to use some scrap bits of card that I've had lying around. I'm going to use crumb cake, I think. I'm going to see how this looks, and then I might change my mind. And I'm just literally laying it on top and creating some layering as if it would have been folded or left with something sat on top. So you've got these different effects. I am gonna bring in soft suede as well, because that's quite light there. And then I can always use this as well where there's some gaps where it's still got white bits. We will be going over with a blending like this so that those white bits are filled in. So you can see the sort of effect I'm going for. In doing this. So I quite like that effect, so I shall continue to do that, and we'll then do some stamping. So you can see how those colours are built up, and you see how I was blending on here but going over on here, so that we've got different sort of stripes appearing on the page as well. I really like that effect, and sort of all those sort of white gaps are sort of filled in now. So now we're going to go over and add some stamps to it. So I'm going to use some soft suede for this. Now I do like to take it off the block, because you can have more sort of subtle effects if you take it off the block, because then you're just putting pressure on different areas and not stamping the whole image, so it's much more random. So you'll probably see a little bit better on this one because it's not so dark. So you can see how I'm not getting the full image, just bits of it. And I quite like that. The other thing I quite like is this one. It does make it look quite like you've coffee stained it. I'm going to leave this one on the block. So in those places where it's smoother, this just gives a really nice subtle splatter, which I have achieved before with coffee staining. And I'm not sure if that is visible on the video, but I do like it as an effect of filling in some of these areas. I might try it with darker, then you can see it a little bit better. I think you can certainly see that a little bit better now, what I mean. Does look a little bit like you might have dropped some coffee on it from a great height, or even a bit of ink. So I really like that effect, and I'm not really going to do much else on the cardstock, because I will be using this to either use for tags or to form pockets under when I've done napkins. So that is my bit of aged cardstock, and then with these I am going on and I'm going to do some postage quite like these. I think I need to re-ink, because I'm going to make envelopes out of these. I quite like this sort of postage mark over it, and then the Franklin, which I'll do over the top. And then we've got some more script that we can add. This is like a handwritten script. Well, the other one is a little bit as well, but it's like different handwriting. So I think I did a page in my journal in this way as well. And then this is more typed. And I think that would do it. So I'll do the other one. And then we'll start making the ephemera. So there's our sheets finished. You can see they look quite different. They are, everyone's unique. So in order to use, it's only copy of paper. So what I did was I took pages from my old dictionary that I got from a charity shop. And this one is virtually 8 1/4 wide, so it fits an A4 sheet quite nicely. So I just stuck them, then I ripped a bit off the end. So I stuck two sheets down, and then one I just ripped up. And what I did, so I didn't have like a big blank space like that in the middle. I overlapped them like that, and then I took one of the pages, just ripped it down the middle and stuck that on the end. So I'm going to stick those on, and then we'll make our envelopes. So that's the paper stuck down, and I'm just going to take my long scissors and trim away at the edge. I've used colour glue. I just decanted it into these little glue bottles that I got. They've got a really fine tip, like a needle thing, and I'm not using as much glue as a result. And as I can't just nip out to where I normally buy my colour from, I thought that was a good idea. And then there are some gaps there, but it depends how this cuts up as to whether or not I'll need to do anything with that. So now I've got a stronger piece, and I really like how it feels with the vintage book page on it. And as I always say, Calal seems to give it a little bit of an extra bit of strength. So I'm gonna do this one in exactly the same way, but I won't bore you with that. So that's my two sheets done. And then to make my envelopes, I used a template that I had from that paper pack that I had. There was some envelopes in it, so I thought, oh, why not use this as a template? So I'm going to go to this side because it's not quite at the end there. So I just put it into the corner. Do it on the back side. I may eventually use the other side. And I've got a soft suede marker, and that's what I'm using to draw around so that it don't matter, because I will be inking around most of the edges anyway. So being able to see this is not a problem. And I got two. And then I use the strips for my faux envelopes. Oops. Drawn on myself there. So I'll do the other one off camera. So there's me envelopes drawn round, and I didn't go particularly neat. You could use a trimmer because it is literally a square, and I thought I could probably work this out. It's not really that difficult, and I probably will work a proper template out for this. And then I just snipped up these triangular bits. Did the other one in the same way, and then I just followed the lines where those little notches were. Folded them up, was not bothered at all that it wasn't necessarily perfect, because it's a junk journal. That really isn't perfect. I may not be bothered. I am a little bit more bothered than that, to be fair. I'd like it to look vaguely rectangle, please, Jez. A little bit better. And then I just trimmed some of these bits off that were hanging over. So when I was happy with how it looked, got a nice sort of envelope shape going on there. So then gave it a good crease, and then I took soft suede and I just inked up all those creased edges. And that's our envelope. So that could get secured, and then you could add something in it, or you can add a journaling spot in there. So this one was done where this was a coffee tart dyed piece of paper, and I just did some stamping, and so the idea I can write in that quite nicely. I did less stamping on that side, so that was a journaling spot. And then then one that I made. So these ones I sealed up to make envelopes, and then I can't find the one where I've stuck stuff in, but this one I gessoed. So you can paint in gesso and then you can write on it. So to make this one, the strip that we're going to have off there, so if I cut that one off, there. So that was literally the strip left, and I cut it into two. So I got two faux envelopes and two actual envelopes out of it. And I just cut it in half, which is there. And I did neaten it up to make sure it was straight. So I sort of took it to about 3 inches so that we got rid of a little bit there. So that we went 3 inches, and then I found the center point at the top, just sort of pinched it a bit, and then folded it down. Folded it down that side. I've watched numerous people do this. I haven't made it up. And just fold the bottom up. I'm just eyeballing. And then fold that down. So the point's nearly at the bottom. And that's the faux envelope, and then I just inked around all these bits. I say I watch Tina from Shabby Dabby Doo Dah. I watch Carol from Carol Tinson. I never, it's something Emporium, I never quite remember what a channel's called, but they are all linked. If you go to nigezza.co.uk, they are linked. And I do watch the Paper Outpost as well. They're the main three go-tos. Oh, and Artie Mays. They're my four go-tos that I watch, but I have watched shed loads. And so I saw several of them do these sort of faux envelopes. So it isn't, I'm not claiming it, not my idea. So I just like to ink all the creases. Gone all the way around? Can't remember. So that's what I did, and then you can stick that down or we can leave it open. And then I did two ways with that. This one I gessoed and then did a little bit of stenciling so that that's able to be written on. And this one, what I did was I stuck the top down and I just stuck some lined paper on, and had that then as a piece of journaling. And then these can just get paper clipped over a page, stuck in a pocket, but just thought they're quite nice little bits of ephemera. And now I'll show you how I did my little folded booklet. So here we have a little folded booklet here. And basically, I had some offcuts, so it was actually a different piece. It was when I used the envelope punch board to make envelopes. I had an offcut left over, but if I just show you by just folding this down, so basically if I fold that in half, so that's in half, and then fold, let's cut this in half. I'm being so unprecise, which is, I've watched lots of nobody uses trimmers that I watch, and so basically I just stuck that down the three sides, did some inking, and then just added two little bits of cardstock to form this little folder, which I thought was pretty good. Another little extra bit for journaling. Obviously I inked all these bits. I haven't actually creased that very well, have I? Not creased it at all, Jez, actually, did you? And so I just creased the centre bit, inked the centre bit. Made sure these edges were all inked up. And then that's ready to get stuck down. And that's a little in there. So just stick those corners down. So stick it on the three sides. So just this will be a much smaller version. And this is the sort of thing why I wanted just cardstock that would just look like it was coffee dyed, to make little inserts. So I do have a bit of coffee dyed cardstock that I was using that I got left over, but I can't find it. So we'll use this piece. So what does this measure? So that's about 2 inches wide. I have stuck, so we'll go for about 1.5. So we'll just take 1.5 inches, which is, I think, just up to the end there. And then how tall is it? 3 inches. So if we go about 2.5, so we'll cut at 5, 2.5, and then they could just fit in there. It could be memorabilia in there, little tickets. That's actually fairly dark for journaling on, but I just wanted to give you the idea. And this envelope that doesn't look like the one I've just made, that looks far neater than the one I've just made. Oh, that is the one I just made. So it is basically 3 by, yeah, it's a little bit more than 3 by. So if we go for 3.5 by 2.5, so 2.5 by 3.5, then that could be little tag that goes in this envelope, and you could either leave it so that that goes in, and then we make a belly band, which I did for one of my envelopes, or as I did for this one, I created a little document seal like that, so put something in. So there's different ways of doing it, but I just thought I really enjoyed making these sort of bits of ephemera, and didn't use any coffee at all, and so I've got a whole bunch of these now ready for decorating in my journal. I've got some more there to make, which I'll probably do when I watch telly a little bit later on. So hope you did enjoy that. I'm just gonna find my journal, there it is, show you where I've used some of these. So I just tucked one in there. So this is why I couldn't find it. So I just stuck a bit on there, done a little circle punch out there to just grab it in, and then that's just a tuck spot. I've got another one there. So this one is just tucked on here. And that was just a bit of coffee dyed paper, actually. And I've just used a stamping up doily there, actually, as a stencil. And that's just paper clipped on there. That is the only ones I've used so far. Yeah, and that's as far as I got. So today, so you've seen me do these pages. I just added a tag there. You saw me do that one, and here I've just added a tuck spot there, and a tuck spot there. Done a little bit of napkin art, which I'll show you in another video. Just made these clusters, you've seen me make those. This one I literally just made a little booklet to stuff in there. That was an envelope in the set, like I used as a template. There, I've just done some sticking down on the, I think I gessoed that, and then I stamped over it. Now this, I've just made an envelope out of the music paper, and I've actually used magnet there. I bought some magnets that aren't that strong, although that does sound it. And I thought, oh, that's a good way of using it up. That's now, because that's now going through several layers of paper, it's not as strong as if I would use it for a bag fastening, but perfect for junk journals. So I'll be doing a few of those. I'll just put some doily around there. Made a belly band here. I don't think I've shown you how I made this tag here. I'll probably do a video on that. Some more of my napkin art that I need to show you. And I showed you how to make those tags. Did another belly band there, and I just decorated this pocket, put some tags in from the set, and yeah, wrapped a doily around there. So yeah, this is coming on, nearly done. So now I've got lots of ephemera now to populate my journal, and we're getting there. Okay, so all details over on my blog, nigezza.co.uk. I will link to it down below. I'll really just put some photos on there and probably give you some brief measurements for these, but really it is what you've seen. Okay, hope you're enjoying this as much as I am, and I'll be back tomorrow with Friday with a tutorial. Yeah, so see you again. Bye. Stay safe. Don't forget to like and subscribe.